In making a movie set on Pandora, Pandora doesn't exist. Which means we are not only designing everything in the world piece by piece, but building it, either in a virtual world or practically on physical sets.
One of the main challenges of designing something from the ground up is not just the design itself, but it's all the details.
To design every single thing in a world, every blade of grass, every leaf, every flower, every bug, it's daunting, but it's fun.
The challenge of designing for Jim, whether it's on the technical side or the natural side, is in Jim's mind, all this stuff is real. We're not making a movie, we're filming some reality that just happens to exist on another planet.
We decided that there were two worlds in collision. You've got the human world, which is highly technological and highly recognizable to us. And then we split off the world of Pandora, the Na'vi, the creatures, the plants, everything in it.
We introduce this whole new world where we have beautiful tropical islands, but also there's a culture that lives in this very large mangrove called the Metcaina. And they have built their whole village suspended over the water under these roots. What's beautiful about Reef Village is that it very much exemplifies the Na'vi belief in connectivity.
This is our home now.
When we are designing creatures for Avatar, we often start with metaphors. The tolkun is evocative of a whale, but when you look at it, this is not a whale at all. There's many, many different things different with it. You may not literally know exactly what is referencing, but you feel it.
Jim gives so much thought to everything that he does, and he expects our stuff to measure up to that level of realism and to be something that the audience just doesn't question. Hell's Gate, as formidable as it may have seemed in Avatar 1, was just a tiny piece of what the RDA is doing. It wasn't the full might that's available back on Earth. The RDA has a lot of money, and they're not messing around, and they're not going to make the same mistake twice. So when they come back on a whole different scale.
Artist, a painter, designer, etc. But I don't think I designed anything on these films. Why would I? I get to work with the best artists in the world. You see these designers, just their brains are exploding with ideas. I just wish I could write a story so comprehensive that I can use all their ideas, but it's just not possible.